Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣圣名说话。
Once again, I give thanks to God for giving us this opportunity to study the book of Revelation.
我再一次的感谢神，让我们有机会一起学习启示录。
We talk about the book has can be divided into two parts.
我们谈到了这个书卷可以分成三个部分。
Two parts.
分成两个部分。
The first part is from chapter 1 to chapter 3.
是第一章，首先是第一章到第三章。
So chapter 1 is a very unique chapter because it talks about the vision of the Son of Man.
第一章是非常特别、非常独特的，因为谈到了人子的形象。
And so many of the features stated in chapter 1 can also be found in chapter 2 and chapter 3.
所以在第一章谈到了很多这些用词、这些字句和教训都可以在第二、第三章找到。
And so the reason or the conclusion that we can derive is that the seven churches had deviated from God simply because the churches did not really know the attributes of God well.
所以我们能得出的一个结论就是那些七个教会里那些有问题的教会他们已经离了神。不清楚神他的神性和本质。
So, today, if you look at our own church,
所以今天如果我们看自己的教会
，so again, many of the problems stem from the fact that we don't really know Jesus.
很多时候问题的产生和发生是因为我们并不是真正的认识主。
Now I want to bring to your attention chapter 1 verse 4 to verse 8.
我希望我们来看。第一章的第四
To me, this is the key section in this chapter.
第四节到这第八节对我来说是整个这第一章的关键。
Here it talks about what Christ has done for us.
这里说了主耶稣他为我们做的事情。
I want you to read verse 5.
我想让各位来读第五节。
Chapter 1, verse 5.
我们来读第五节。
And from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler over the kings of the earth, to him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood.
第五节，并那诚实做见证的，从死里首先复活，为世上君王元首的耶稣基督，有恩惠平安归于你们。他爱我们，用自己的血使我们脱离罪恶。
We can also cross-reference to chapter 5, verse 9.
我们可以在这节在这个第五章的第九节这里看到。
And they sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by your blood, out of every tribe, and tongue, and people, and nation."
这第九节第五章第九节这里说，他们唱新歌说，你配拿书卷，配揭开七印。因为你曾被杀，用自己的血从各族、各方、各民、各国中买了人来，叫他们归于神。
Here it talks about the redemptive work of Jesus Christ.
这里说了主耶稣他救赎的工作。
When we look at the chapter 1,
那我们来看第一章的话。
Verse 5, yeah.
第五节。
And here it says, just now we have read, it says, who loved us.
是些他说他爱我们。
How much do we know about the work of Christ?
所以如何去知道主的工作
you know, he has died for us on the cross.
就是我们都知道主在十字架为我们而死。
We said that is the climax of Christ's love for the entire fallen humanity.
我们说那个是在人类的罪恶里面的最主救赎的最高潮的地方。
Because, you know, Jesus Christ, being God Himself, came in the flesh to die for us.
因为主他原是神，但降世为人，为我们而死。
So the question is, can we truly understand and feel that, you know, Jesus truly loves us?
所以我们要问自己是否真的明白并且了解主耶稣爱我们。
I think for us who have children, if our children have grown up, you know, and they really appreciate what we have done, you know, for them, they will tend to listen to us.
我想对我们有儿女的来说，若儿女他们长大，他们真的明白我们是爱他们的，那他们事实上会更愿意去听我们在说什么。
Because you know they want to show appreciation, you know, or we say repay the love that we have given to them.
因为他们想要去回馈去我们所给他们的爱。
Likewise, when we talk about loving God, yeah.
那就像我们在说要爱神。
Why do we need to keep the commandments? Why should we keep His commandments?
为什么要去守神的诫命？
According to John, yeah, because we love God.
那约翰他说了，是因为我们爱神。
You know, God has loved us so much, and He's, you know, and He has sacrificed His life for us.
因为神他爱我们，他为我们牺牲他的命。
If we truly moved by His love.
那所以，若我们真的被他的爱所激励
，then we'll do whatever we can, you know, to keep His commandments.
我们有不论遇到不论如何，我们都一定会去遵守他的诫命。
We find that we will want the church to grow.
我们就会希望教会成长。
We'll do everything that we can to make sure that the church will become better.
我们会竭尽所能去让教会变得更好。
Because Jesus loves us.
因为主爱我们。
So if we don't have this, how can I say understanding?
那所以如果我们没有这样子的一个认识，
又如何说自己有这个认识呢？ Oh, in our life, we cannot feel the love of God in this manner.
如果我们没有办法去感受到神的爱，
Chances are that we will turn our own church, our own churches, you know, into, you know, churches like the seven churches.
那有很大的几率，我们会将自己的教会变成像这七个教会一样。
Will allow, you know, all sort of corruptions, you know, or whatever, you know, evil things to happen in the church.
那我们会让这个教会有腐败，有很多罪恶的事。
When you see that the church is far from being perfect.
那所以当我们看见一个教会它离完全很远。
Or if a church, within a church, the members, the workers do not show any keen interest, you know, in improving themselves.
或是在教会里的工人，他们对自我的成长没有任何的兴趣，
or do not have the desire to make the church better，
也没有让教会成长的动力和欲望。
It means that, you know, the church does not really know the love of Jesus.
那就代表这个教会并不是真的明白主耶稣的爱。
That's why, you know, chapter 1 is so important, not only to the seven churches, but also to the end time true Jesus church.
所以启示录的第一章，它不止对当时那七个教会很重要，对我们现今真教会也是至关重要的。
I want you to read verse 6, chapter 1, verse 6.
我希望我们来读第六节。
Chapter 1, verse 6, and has made us kings and priests to his God and Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen.
第六节，又使我们成为国民，做他父神的祭司，但愿荣耀全能归于他，直到永永远远。阿们。
We were sinners before.
我们在过去是罪人。
We belong to the domain of darkness.
我们是属于这黑暗的权柄的。
And we are under the clutches of Satan.
那我们是我们是被撒旦控制的。
We had no freedom before.
我们在过去没有自由。
Now you can see how great His grace is towards us.
但是我们可以看到主耶稣他的对我们的恩惠恩典是如何。
You know, for us who believe in Him, He made us kings and priests.
我们相信他的，他让我们成为国民和祭司。
You can see a radical transformation of status from being slaves of sin to being children of God.
我们可以看见我们自己身份上很大的一个转变，从一个罪的奴仆奴隶，变成神的。
Seriously, sometimes we have to ask questions, you know, how much we actually understand the love of God for us.
对，有时候我们实际上一定要真的要去问问自己，是否真的明白神为我们做了什么。
Now we are God's children.
那我们现在是神的儿女。
We are above all the other nations in this entire world.
我们已经超乎了在这世上的万民万族。
Should we not, you know, repay, you know, our love, repay the love of God?
既是如此，难道我们不应该去回报神的爱吗？
I want you to read the Exodus.
我想我们来读这个出埃及记。
Return to Exodus chapter 19.
出埃及记十九章。
Exodus chapter 19.
出埃及记十九章。
We read verse 4.
你读第四节。
We can read from verse 3.
可以从第三节开始读。
And Moses went up to God, and the Lord called to him from the mountain, saying, Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel, Verse 4, you have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle's wings, and brought you to myself.
第三节，摩西到神那里，主从山上呼唤他说，你要这样告诉雅各家小与以色列人说，第四节，我向埃及人所行的事，你们都看见了，且看见我如鹰将你们背在翅膀上带来归我。
These two verses talk about, you know, the great deliverance that God has for his people.
那这两节说到了神对他的百姓施行了拯救。
So how he saved them, you know, from the Egyptians.
他如何救他们脱离埃及人的手？
In verse 4, we are told that he bore them on, you know, eagle wings.
那第四节我们看到他将他们背在翅膀上，鹰的翅膀上
to himself,
来带来去归他。
If you look at this, you know, act of God is not only a great act of deliverance, but also an actions of great love.
那所以说我们看到神在这里所施行的事就。让我们可以看见，不仅仅他施行了大拯救，而是有他的大爱在。
Just like us today, you know, we were in Egypt before in the world.
那就像我们现今，我们过去在埃及。
By the mighty power of God, we were saved, we were delivered.
但因着神的大能，我们被拯救出来。
So, you know, and therefore we should keep the commandments of God, like what is stated in verse 5.
那也就是因着如此，我们就要像在第五节。这里说到的要去持守去守神的诫命。
Now therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, then you shall be special treasure to me above all people, for all the earth is mine.
第五节这里就说了，如今你们若实在听从我的话，遵守我的约，就要在万民中做属我的子民，因为全地都是我的。
So, you know, because of what God has done,
因为神他所做的
and therefore God's people must adhere to his commandments.
所以他的百姓就要去遵从他的命令。
In fact, you know, keeping the commandment of God is how can I say, is something that God wants to show his love still further to us.
那其实要去守神的诫命也是神他要在让我们去看到他的爱。更多的爱
so that we will not fall back to sin.
那这样子能够保守我们不再坠落回黑暗。
So with this, when you look at the seven churches,
所以如果我们来看这七个教会
it means that they have failed to understand, you know, the great love that God has shown to them.
那这七个教会他们就是没有去明白和看见神给他们的大爱。
I guess, you know, if every one of us here can understand God's love fully,
如果我们今天在座的都能够去完全明白神的爱
You will see love in the church.
我们在教会也就能够看到爱
You will see unity in the church.
我们在教会就能看见合一
You will see complete harmony in the church.
我们在教会能够看到完全的和谐
There shall be no fighting in the church.
在教会不会有任何的纷争
Because we know that God has loved us so much.
因为我们明白神非常爱我们
We must repay his love.
我们要回报他的爱
By keeping peace and harmony in the church.
来借着在教会有平安和和谐来回报他。
So if there is conflict in the church, it only goes to show that, you know, the church has not fully understood the love of Jesus.
所以如果今天一个教会有纷争有争执那就代表教会里我们并不是真的明白神的爱和他的真理。
If Jesus Christ can sacrifice so much for us,
如果今天主耶稣他能够为我们牺牲这么多
If we were wrong in the church by someone,
如果我们今天在教会被人得罪
We won't mind anymore because of the love of Jesus.
我们就会不以为意因为主耶稣为我们牺牲这么多了
If the love of Jesus is always strong in our heart,
若主的爱在我们心中是非常强大
We find that the love of Jesus will generate, you know, this, what you call it, melting power to melt away all our differences.
我们就能够去感受到这主的爱，它好像就是一个能够去融化一切的力量。
All these differences will be melted away.
那所有的差异都会被融化。
Because all of us are filled with the love of Jesus.
因为我们每一位都被主的爱充满。
That's why, you know, we have to pray in the Spirit.
那这才是为什么我们要在灵里祷告。
Only when we pray in the Spirit, then God will pour His love into our hearts.
当我们只有当我们在灵里祷告，神他会将他的爱浇灌给我们。
When a person prays in the Spirit, it means that in prayer he is willing to submit to the authority and the power of God.
当一个人他愿意在灵里祷告，是代表他在灵里他完全的去顺服神。
He is willing to follow God's words.
他愿意去完全的遵行守神的诫命。
He is willing to put aside his own ideas and his own opinions.
他愿意将自己的己见放置一边。
So that the church can be benefited.
让这个教会能够得着益处。
So we have to pray for the church.
所以我们一定要为教会祷告。
Pray in the Spirit.
我们要在灵里祷告。
Meaning allow the Spirit to intercede for us according to the will of God.
要让这个圣灵在为我们照着神的旨意为我们祈祷。
Then you see transformation, you know, in the church.
那我们在教会就能够看到转变。
The church will be completely different.
教会也就会完全的不一样。
All this so-called misunderstanding, hatred, you know, will be melted away.
那所有的误解，所有的恨憎恨都会被溶解。
I'm not sure if you have this experience yourself.
我不晓得各位有没有这样的经历。
You find that if we are not peaceful within,
有时候会觉得自己心里不平安。
It can be full of suspicion. Is that not true?
就会好像对于万事都充满了这个怀疑。
You are suspicious of this. You're suspicious of that.
你就会疑神疑鬼。
You generate a lot of confusion in your own mind.
你在你的这个意念里面，脑海里面会有很多的很多的不明白。
As a result, you know, you create a lot of mistrust.
那也因此如此，你就去创造了很多的不信任。
Sometimes I said to myself,
有时候我就会跟自己说
，How am I going to pray?
我要如何祷告
？How am I going to work together with others?
我要怎么和他人同工
？It's not possible.
有点困难啊。
Alright, so.You know, we need to think, you know, about Jesus and His love because these are things which are positive.
那这才是为什么我们要反复的去思想主耶稣的爱，因为这是正面。
Because the love of God, yeah, is powerful.
因为神的爱有大能力。
You know, if you try to patch up differences by using our own means, you can never, you know, achieve anything.
所以有时候，如果我们是要靠着自己，然后去这个。填补这个差异的话，有时候我们是做不到。
The entire church must come back to God, must return to God.
因为教会里的所有人，这个整个教会都要回到神面前。
You can see problems in the seven churches.
我们在这个启示录里看到七个教会的问题。
Because they have all failed, you know, I mean, five out of the seven churches have failed to understand the love of Jesus.
那其中五个教会，他们失败了，因为没有去明白神的爱。
We look at the second section. It's from chapter 4 all the way to chapter 22.
那再过来是启示录的第二个部分，第四章到第二十二章。
Chapter 4 to chapter 22.
第四章到第二十二章。
And again, you find that chapter 4 is quite a unique chapter.
这一次我们看第四章的话，这也是一个非常特别的。
Because John saw the throne of God in heaven.
因为约翰他看见神在天上的宝座。
I want you to look at chapter 4.
我们来看第四章。
We read verse 2.
我们看第二节。
Chapter 4 verse 2.
第四章第二节。
And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne set in heaven, and one sat on the throne.
第二节，我立刻被圣灵感动，见有一个宝座安置在天上，又有一位坐在宝座上。
This is a heavenly scene.
这是一个天上的场景。
John was able to see it because he was in the spirit.
约翰他能够看到，因为他在灵里面。
We can put it this way: for any one of us to enter into this state of existence, we have to be in the spirit at all times.
我们可以说，如果我们想要去 看到去进入到这天上的场景，那我们就一定是在圣灵里，在灵里面。
So if we want, you know, the church to be like this,
所以如果我们希望教会就像这样，
then all of us must be in the Spirit.
我们每一位都要在圣灵里。
So we live according to the Spirit. We are led by the Holy Spirit.
我们被圣灵引导，去靠着圣灵活着。
We know that the church will face with a lot of challenges and will face with the great tribulation.
我们都知道教会它会受到逼迫，会有很多的挑战。
This is how we can prepare ourselves to face all these challenges ahead.
也是只有在灵里我们能够去预备自己。
Now we look at some of the details, some of the teachings that we can derive from this chapter.
从这个第四章里面我们可以去细读，然后看见很多的教训和细节。
I would say again, the key feature here is the throne.
那我也来说，这第四章它最主要的就是这天上的宝座。
God, you know, is the one who sits on the throne.
这个宝座由神坐在上面。
You also see that here it mentioned about this 24 elders.
第四章里面也说了有，也谈到了24位长老。
And we can read verse 4.、Yeah?
我们可以读第四节。
Now around the throne were 24 thrones, and on the thrones I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white robes, and they had crowns of gold on their heads.
第四节，宝座的周围又有24个座位，其上坐着24位长老，身穿白衣，头上戴着金冠冕。
We also see that there are four living creatures.
我们也看到四活物。
We read verse 6.
第六节。
So before the throne was, there was a sea of glass like crystal, and in the midst of the throne and around the throne were four living creatures full of eyes in front and in back.
第六节，宝座前好像一个玻璃海，如同水晶。宝座中和宝座周围有四个活物，前后遍体都满了眼睛。
You know, 24 elders and four living creatures, they are like two sets of workers.
24个长老，24位长老，四活物，就好像是两组工人。
How do they, the elders adorn themselves?
所以这24位长老，他们是他们穿着是怎么样子呢？
We re-look at verse 4 again.
我们再看第四节。
Here we are told they're clothed in white robes and they had crowns of gold on their heads.
这里说了他们身穿白衣，头上戴着金冠冕。
We said white robes being they have attained to the holiness and godliness that God desires.
这身穿白衣就代表他们已经达到了神他要的圣洁。
And godliness as well.
还有虔诚。
So you know, these are the people who were qualified to come before God.
所以这些人他们是有资格去到神的面前。
We know that in order to stand firm in the last day.
然后我们都知道，在末日要能够站立得住。
The way forward is not to think about, you know, methods or whatever, you know, to overcome dangers.
不仅仅是说要去克服危险。
The most important thing that we need to do is to come before God.
最重要的是我们要回到神的面前。
And we also realize that to come before God, we are required to cleanse ourselves.
但是要回到神的面前，我们就要洁净自己。
So we know that this is never easy.
但是这个并不是容易的事。
But this is the standard that God has set for us.
但是这个是神他给我们的标准。
If we do not draw close to God,
如果我们没有来亲近神，
and if our worship and service to God remains only superficially,
如果我们的崇拜和侍奉仅仅只是在表面，
we find that when the great tribulation comes, no one will be able to stand.
我们就会发现，当真正的逼迫和患难到的时候，没有人能够站立得住。
I just want to help you understand a bit more.
我想让各位有更深入的了解。
Now we turn to chapter 11.
当我们翻到启示录十一章。
And to understand why is it so important to come close to the throne.
我们就可以去明白为什么来到宝座前是这么重要。
When you look at the temple structure.
如果我们来看这个 神的殿的一个结构。
In the book of Revelation, there are two parts.
在启示录有两个部分。
Briefly speaking, the outer court and the inner court.
这圣殿的结构有内殿和外殿。
So you find that there are many people remain in the outer court.
我们就发现有很多人他们就留在殿
外。We are talking about believers here.
这里说的这些人是信徒。
And what did what was John told?
约翰，他听见他。听见什么?
I want you to read verse 2.
我们来读第二节。
But leave out the court which is outside the temple and do not measure it, for it has been given to the Gentiles, and they will tread the holy city underfoot for 42 months.
那你看这第二节他就说了，只是殿外的院子要留下，不用量，因为这是给了外邦人的，他们要践踏圣城42个月。
It seems that up to this point in time, God has given up on the outer court.
这里好像看似神他已经放弃了殿外的人。
It's like anyone who is not found in the inner court will face with the great wrath of the Lord.
那就是这些在不在内殿的人，他们会去要承受神大的愤怒。
You can see this in chapter 15.
在十五章我们就看得到。
That's why when you look at chapter 4.
那所以当我们来看启示录第四章
，you find that the 24 elders actually surround the throne of God.
我们就可以看见这二十四位长老他们是围绕在神的周神的宝座
周围 They are very close to God.
非常与神非常的亲近
Anyone who desires to draw close to God will require to change their way, his ways of life, his thinking and the way he conducts himself.
我们每一个想要去亲近神在神周围的人都要去心意更新，就要去改变自己的行为和心思意念。
So in this way, you know, he will purify himself.
也就借着如此，我们能够去洁净自己。
Only those who are with white robes can withstand, trials and tribulations and the onslaughts of Satan.
因为只有身穿白衣，我们才能够在这个大逼迫和撒旦的攻击下去站立得住。
Now the four living creatures. Why is it that the four living creatures are mentioned?
那为什么这里又提到了四活物呢
？We also see that the four living creatures are mentioned in the book of Ezekiel.
我们在以西结书里面也能够看到四活物的记载。
The four, the living creatures are with four faces each.
那四活物他们有四个脸
And the first one is the face of a man
一个是人的脸
And the second is the face of an ox
一个是牛的脸
And the third is the face of a lion
一个是狮子的脸
And the fourth is eagle
第四是鹰飞鹰的脸
What do they represent?
这些都代表什么
You know, when we talk about when God first created man
当神他在起初创造人的时候
God created man according to his image
神他借着自己的形象来造人
So the face of man represents the nobility of a person that God has given to him
那所以一个这个人脸他是代表了神他给人的尊贵
And what does an ox represent?
那这牛是代表什么
Diligence and submission
那是一个用心然后认真和顺服的，一个非常勤劳的
，and some very submissive，
也非常顺服
，is an obedient，
很服从。
In the Bible, you know, lion can also means what victory。
那这个狮子在圣经里面就像是得胜。
Eagle，
飞鹰。
Is high up in the sky, meaning you know we have to live a life that is detached from the influence and the worldliness of the world.
那飞鹰它在天上飞，那代表我们今天也要脱离这个世界上的潮流和掌控。
Only those who possess this kind of characteristics can draw close to God.
那也只有当我们有这些特质，我们才能够去亲近神。
This is very important, especially when we talk about getting ourselves prepared for the second coming of Christ.
那这些非常的重要，尤其是当我们在预备主再来的时候。
You know, do we have the submissions of the ox?
我们是否有像牛一样的服从和顺服
？I guess this is important for us all to understand.
我想这对我们来说 是很重要的一个认识。
Okay, well, when I want you to look at verse 9,
我想让各位来读第九节。
Sorry, we read from verse 8.
我们从第八节开始读。
The four living creatures, each having six wings, were full of eyes around and within, and they do not rest day or night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, who was and is and is to come.
第八节，四活物各有六个翅膀，遍体内外都满了眼睛。他们昼夜不住地说：“圣哉，圣哉，圣哉！主神是昔在、今在、以后永在的全能者。”
You find that you know they devoted themselves, yeah, like full time, yeah, to praising God.
那这里我们就看到他们昼夜的来赞美神。
So praising God is their primary task.
这个赞美神是他们最主要的工作。
So, you know, when we talk about our life, what is our primary task in our life?
当我们反观自己的生活，什么是我们最主要的要做的事情呢？
We all understand that we are very busy with our life. We have to work in order to sustain our livelihood, you know, to feed our children.
我们都感觉自己生活非常的繁忙，因为要去抚养，要喂养自己的家庭。
But according to the scriptures, our main task is to praise God and to worship God.
但在经上，它记载的是说，我们最主要的工作是要去来赞美神。
You find that this is so necessary.
所以我们就会去我们也能够去看到说，这个是是我们非常需要、务必要去做的。
So when we do this, yeah, we actually what?Foster a very good relationship with God.
因为当我们这么做的时候，我们和神是去拥有一个很好的、良好的关系。
If we don't worship God, we don't praise God. You know, you find that you know our relationship with God will become more and more distant.
那如果我们今天没有去崇拜神，没有去敬拜神，没有赞美神，我们和他的关系就越来越遥远。
We will not, you know, feel that you know God is close to us.
我们会觉得自己和神并不是那么的亲近。
So to draw close to God requires us to worship Him in spirit and in truth.
所以要去亲近神，就代表我们要心灵和诚实来敬拜他。
And this is something that we have to do.
那这也是我们一定要去做。
Every time when we come before God in the church,
当我们每一次来到教会
we have to make sure that our heart is right and is pure before Him.
我们要去确保自己的心在他面前是无亏欠的。
At the least, we must pursue to be pure and to be right before Him.
那我们在他面前要去追求成为圣洁。
Now we look at verse 9 onwards.
那再读第九节的话。
Now, so whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to Him who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before Him who sits on the throne and worship Him.Who lives forever and ever and cast their crowns before the throne. He's saying,
第九节，每逢四活物将荣耀、尊贵、感谢归给那坐在宝座上、活到永永远远者的时候，第十节，那二十四位长老就俯伏在坐宝座的面前，敬拜那活到永永远远，又把他们的冠冕放在宝座前。
24 elders respond, you know, to what the four living creatures, you know, are doing.
那所以这二十四位长老他们就去呼应了四活物做的事情。
He said there are two sets of believers. There's two sets of workers here.
所以在这里我们看见有两组工人。
They know how to complement one another.
他们知道如何去让彼此互相搭配。
So I guess in the church we need to do the same.
所以在教会我们也要这么做。
You know, to prepare ourselves for the second coming of Jesus,require us to learn to work with one another.
所以当我们在准备主再来的时候，我们要去学习如何与他人搭配工作。
The more we serve God, the more harmonious we should be with one another.
当我们与他人的同工越来越和谐。
You know, if we work with one another and we see that our environment is become more and more hostile.
当我们若在与他人同工，发现怎么越做越就越做越差劲，越环境越来越恶劣。
It means that you know we don't really know what we are doing.
这或许是在告诉我们，其实我们不清楚自己在做什么。
Now, I think one of the things that is mentioned is in verse 10 that we need to pay attention to.
那我想在这第十节他说的说这里所记载的是我们要特别去注意的。
So what did the 24 elders do?
所以这24位长老他们做了什么？
Aside from worshiping God,
除了他们敬拜神。
Now it mentions that they cast their crowns before the throne.
他们说这里说了他们俯伏在做宝座的面前。
What is the Lord trying to teach us here?
主耶稣他在这里是要教导我们什么呢？
I think you know, for us who serve God, we have received much rewards and blessing from Him.
那当我们在侍奉神的时候，我们好像会看见神的恩典和祝福。
So we must cast all these crowns before the throne.
那所以我们要将我们这些冠冕就放下，放在宝座前。
What does that mean?
这是什么意思？
It means that all the achievement that we have received actually come from God.
就是我们得到的所有的成就，这些都是从神而来的。
We must be able to recognize this from the bottom of our heart.
我们从心底一定要去明白。
Whatever position we are given to serve in the church, we need to understand that this is appointed by God.
无论今天我们在教会担任什么样子的职务。都是神由神来选的。
If we have this understanding, it means that we humble ourselves before God.
那如果我们有这样清晰的一个认识，那就是代表我们在神面前谦卑。
Why is there conflict in the church?
为什么在教会有纷争？
Is it not because of pride?
难道不就是因为骄傲吗？
Is it not because of our own ego, our own face?
难道不是因为我们的自我和面子？
We can look at a verse.
我们可以看一个经节。
We turn to Proverbs chapter 13.
我们翻到箴言十三章。
We turn to Proverbs chapter 13.
箴言十三章。
We read verse 10.
第十节。
13 verse 10, but pride comes nothing but strife.
第十节这里说了，骄傲只起争竞。
When you see strife in the church,
当我们在教会看见争执，
surely you know it comes from pride.
那这其实就是因着骄傲而来的。
So don't take this as something normal. It's not normal.
所以不要觉得这个好像是一个平常事。
We must not normalize what is not normal.
我们不应该将一个不平常的事情正常化。
We must get rid of what is not normal in the sight of God.
我们应该要在把这些在神眼中看为不正常的事情驱离出去。
We also can read chapter 10 of Proverbs.
我们也可以看到也可以来看箴言第十章。
Proverbs chapter 10.
箴言第十章。
We read verse 12.
我们来读十二节。
Chapter 10 verse 12.
第十章十二节。
Hatred stirs up strife.But love covers all sins.
恨能挑起争端，爱能遮掩一切过错。
Sometimes we see strife in the church because of the work of hatred in the heart.
有时候我们在教会看见争端，就是因为心里的恨。
Because we cannot get over a situation or over, you know, we cannot forgive somebody who has wronged us.
因为我们没有办法放下那些得罪过我们的人。
So when we gather together, like so in meeting or whatever, you see strife.
那所以当我们与他人聚集开会的时候，等等，就可以看见争端。
And you know this is not the way to prepare ourselves for the second coming of Christ.
但这些不是一个我们应当去用的方式来预备主耶稣的再来。
We read chapter 8 of Proverbs.
我们再来看的这个箴言第八章。
Verse 13.
十三节
，Chapter 8 verse 13，
第八章十三节。
And the fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride and arrogance, and the evil ways, and the perverse mouth I hate。
第十三节，敬畏主在乎恨恶邪恶，那骄傲狂妄并恶道以及乖谬的口，都为我所恨恶。
For now, we just focus on the second part of this verse, verse 13.
那在我们来看这个十三节的第二部分。
Pride and arrogance is like, you know, what can I say? A state of mind, yeah? is within a person.
那这个骄傲
的 person，
这个骄傲和狂妄是一个人他的他的心理的东西。
No, evil ways like you know you can see is a conduct。
那这个恶道是一个行为，是我们外人看得见的。
And then followed by the perverse mouth mean words。
那一个怪谬的口就是他说出来的话。
So you find that pride and arrogance can actually generate what evil ways and perverse mouth。
那所以骄傲和狂妄是内心里的东西，它是可以去产生出邪恶的道。
So we must not allow this to happen in the church。
所以我们不要让这些事情发生在教会里面。
Otherwise, we'll become, you know, one of the corrupt churches stated in the book of Revelation。
要不然的话，我们就会变成这个教会就会变成那腐败的教会一样。
So you know, to get ourselves prepared, we must be willing to cast our crowns before the throne。
所以，若要去预备我们自己，我们就要将头上的冠冕去拿下来。
Meaning that we are willing to humble ourselves，
代表我们愿意去谦卑自己。
Whatever we have today, whatever position we may be in，
不论我们今天拥有什么，又或是处在什么样子的职位，
we need to understand that all this come from the Lord. There is nothing that we should boast about。
我们都要去明白，一切都是从神而来，没有任何事情是值得我们去夸口的。
So chapter 4 is a chapter that teaches us how to get ourselves ready for the second coming of Christ。
那所以启示录的第四章是为了要来预备我们，来准备好自己，主的再次到来。
Okay, we can look at chapter 22。
那我们来看22章。
So here it talks about those who serve here before the throne of God。
那二十二章这里是谈到了在神面前，在神的宝座面前侍奉人。
So you can see that between chapter 4 and chapter 22。
那所以当我们看第四章和第二十二章。
All these chapters in between tell us about the struggle that the church will go through before the church reaches perfection。
那在第四章到二十二章里面就记载了当这个教会要成为完全之前所会经历的一切事。
It also teaches us how we can actually come before the Lord and to serve Him。
也教导了我们如何能够来到神的面前侍奉他。
In the process, we have to what fight many battles。
但在这个过程里，我们有很多的征战。
One of the key battles is to fight against ourselves。
其中有一个很重要的征战是与自己的。
We have to overcome。
我们要战胜自己。
That's why in the seven churches we see that it always end with those who overcome, you know, they will receive God's blessing。
那这才是为什么我们能够看到在这给七个教会的书信的最后一部分，就是你们得胜了会如何如何。
Likewise, in chapter 21, you also see that this teaching is restated。
那在启示录二十一章里面，我们也可以再次看到这个教训被重新重申出来。
Do you know how great the blessing is if we can overcome？
但是我们是否真的去明白得胜之后所能得到的福气是什么？
Before I conclude, please read chapter 21。
在我结束之前，我们来读二十一章。
Chapter 21, we read verse。We read verse。verse 7,
21章的第七节。
21 verse 7,
21章第七节。
He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
21章第七节，得胜的必承受这些伟业，我要做他的神，他要做我的儿子。
In other words, yeah, if we are not victorious,
换句话说，若我们今天没有得胜，
we may be disowned by God.
我们就会被神遗弃。
So we all need to be victorious。
所以我们一定要得胜。
Over to be victorious over our own shortcomings, our own weaknesses。
要得胜自己的短板，得胜自己的软弱。
Only then, you know, God shall be our God。
那只有如此，神他才做我们的神。
That is the victory that we must receive。
这是我们一定要得着的胜利。
You know, God must be our God, and that must be recognized by God Himself。
那神他一定要成为我们的神，那他一定要将我们承认为他的儿子。
We shall continue tomorrow。
我们明天继续。
Let's pray in silence。
一起默祷。